Defense Minister Rajnath Singh conveyed his Chinese counterpart that the behavior of Chinese troops violated the bilateral agreement between China and India. He reminded them that they cannot change the status quo unilaterally and stated both the ministries should act responsibly without complicating the situation. He urged his Chinese counterpart to return to disengagement talks and withdraw Chinese troops from all friction points. Athar Hussain, spokesperson and secretary of Indo-Islamic Cultural Foundation, stated the masjid to be built in Dhanipur village of Ayodhya will be exactly 15,000 square feet, the size of Babri Masjid before it was demolished in 1992. Professor Iksam Athar, the dean of Jamia Millia Islamia's architecture department, will head the design of masjid and its surrounding complex, which also includes a hospital. Maharashtra government announced the release of 16.5 crore to help flood-affected people in Nagpur division. Maharashtra CMO tweeted that the fund will be utilized to provide financial aid to repair houses and build shelters. India's first bullet train may fail to meet the 2023 deadline. Low participation by Japanese companies, cancellation of tenders owing to high rates by bidders, and coronavirus are few of the reasons for the delay. The deadline of the bullet train, planned to run between Ahmedabad and Mumbai at a speed of 320 km per hour, has now been extended to 2028. Securities and Exchange Board of India decided to confiscate the bank and DMAT accounts of Mehul Choksi, Geetanjali Gems and its executive director Dhanesh Sheth. The decision came in after they failed to pay the fine of Rs. 5 crores. The fine was imposed on them for violating norms including listing regulations. Condemning Islamic separatism, French President Macron has defended right to commit blasphemy. Statement came amid the Charlie Hebdo shooting trials going on and furore over the republication of the images. Macron said, "To be French is to defend the right to make people laugh, to criticize, to mock, to caricature." French government has also promised a law against Islamic separatism soon. Russian COVID-19 vaccine Sputnik V has shown antibody responses with no side effects. Vaccine also produced T cells in first two phase trials. Interestingly, antibody responses were higher in post-vaccination immunity than convalescent plasma. Russia is planning to commence with the vaccination of medical personnel and teachers. International Atomic Energy Agency detailed Iran's increasing uranium stockpile. IAEA's report said that as of August 25th, Iran had over 2,000 kilograms of low-enriched uranium, adding 534 to its May 20 stock. Iran is a signatory to 2015 nuclear deal, which allowed it to keep only 202 kilograms. Amazon to set up its third headquarters in Seattle. This new office will have 25,000 workers with an average annual salary of $1,50,000. The office would be 2 million square feet as the company is seeking permission to build another skyscraper in the city. Samsung's upcoming Galaxy S20 Fan Edition had a major leak by revealing all of the phone's key specifications. New Samsung flagship S20 FE will be available in two configurations with a 4G OLE Exynos 990 trim and a 5G capable Snapdragon 865 powered model. According to sources, it will have triple camera setup with a 12 megapixel main camera.
Thank you for listening to Briefly News. Have a wonderful evening.